Hi everyone, my name is Patrick, scored 100 percentile in CAT 6 times. This specific video is basically how to prepare for CAT verbal section for a 2-hour paper. So the CAT 2-hour paper has 40 minutes of verbal section. So how do you plan prepare for the same? So let's compare a 2-hour paper and a 3-hour paper, the difference. Basically in a 2-hour paper or in a 3-hour paper you have 34 questions in 60 minutes, which is 1.76 minutes per question. And if I look at a 2-hour paper, you have 40 minutes and 26 questions. Less time per question if you look at it. So that means they've reduced the time from 60 to 40, but they've not reduced the questions proportionately. So technically you have more number of questions to solve. And if you plan to solve all questions, you have to solve 15 minutes faster, which is, you know, creates more stress and may not be really great. But anyway, how do you go about doing it? So let's start with a major portion of the paper, which is reading comprehension. Reading comprehension still constitutes the major part of the paper. So it was 70%, it's still 69%. So not much has changed in terms of proportion of the paper. Parasympathy number of questions have remained the same, but otherwise the parajumbles have reduced and odd one out have reduced. But yeah, major portion of the paper is still reading comprehension, and there is nothing called vocabulary based questions and grammar based questions in the whole paper. So in that case, the focus will still be reading. So if you're going to prepare, ensure that you read a lot. Okay, focus still on reading, because RC, parasummary, odd one out, all are based on reading. So if you read regularly, it will definitely help. Read something that you like. Enjoy reading. And that is what will help you build on your verbal section. Apart from that, paper strategy is what will be the major concern. So you'll have to balance between high attempts and high accuracy. Look, initially if you had to solve a lot of questions, it was fine because number of questions were comparatively lower in terms of time, okay, per unit time. But now there are more number of questions per time. So if you rush to solve more questions, that is all the questions in the paper, the speed may lead to lower accuracy. So in that case, there could be a possibility that you may have to balance between going for high attempts or going for high accuracy. In that case, experiment a lot. See, in some of the papers, try to go fast and see how does it work. Some other papers, try to go slow and see how does it work. See, does your marks increase or decrease? What happens in the overall? So analyze the paper. And only once you experiment, you will know what works for you, what doesn't work for you. Normally, I recommend people to read the way they normally read. But yes, there's no harm in experimenting in the examination to find how it pans out. Okay, analyze your marks per minute. And that is a term that you need to use for every part of the paper analysis. Look, normally in the earlier paper, 34 questions, you could maybe solve all the questions. But in this type of question, 40 minutes, 26 questions, it is a little difficult to solve all the questions. So that means in case if you are leaving a question, you should know which type of questions you are going to leave. Is it going to be RC, jumble para, odd man out, parasummary? Which you'll only come to know if you analyze how much marks per minute you get per section. So whenever you solve a paper, find out the marks that you get per area and the time that you have taken, and find the marks per minute. So wherever you get the least marks per minute, you should keep for the end, so that if you leave it, you leave that part of the paper. And wherever you get high marks per minute, ensure that you solve it in the examination. Even RC, you can break it up into different type of passages. So passage you're comfortable with, passage you're not, type of passage, etc. Find out marks per minute for different type of questions, and that will help you to build your proper paper strategy. Experiment, and that is what will work for you. Hope that helps. Thank you.